A people united shall never be defeated.
Thank you.
Bunge la mwananchi imefaili hiyo koti katika East African Court of Justice, na inafaa serikali Kenya alikuwa served kwamba serikali ya Kenya iende kujibu hiyo mashtaka katika East African Court of Justice. Kwa sababu hiyo mambo bunge la mwananchi imepeleka katika East African Court of Justice. Na jambo
tunaomba yale petition wameweka kule East African Court of Justice, wana majeshi ipate kibali. Tazama, ni vijana wadogo wenye maono, wenye nguvu, ambao hawajachanganyikiwa, ambao wako na imani. Kristo Yesu Bwana, ninakushukuru jioni ya siku hii ya leo. Bwana wa majeshi, wewe ndiwe uliyetuita kuwa makuhani, Mungu wa Israeli. Wala hubagui umri, wala ukoo, wala popote Bwana. Wewe unaangalia yule aliye tayari kutumika. Bwana, ukatuita ukatufanya watumishi wa kila mtu, wa kila nafsi.
Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe.
Kwa sekunde kumi fungua kinywa chako. You acknowledge this God. Umwambia Yakoba, Bwana najua. You are more than able and you're gonna do it in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you and we honor you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Asante Yesu. Katika jina la Mungu Baba. And also to pray for our brothers and sisters ambao hawapatikani na ambao wamepitia thulma. Tuambie ya kwamba sisi kama kanisa, we are together with you, we are praying with you, and we believe that our God is going to do it for us. Amen. Amen. Na kwa hivyo ningetaka kumwarika mwenzangu Reverend akuje na ili atuongoze na ombi. Na akimaliza kutuongoza na ombi, tutaimba pambio moja ya kumwabudu Bwana. Amen.
Amen.
Ninajua
ya maana sana kwetu. My name is Sir Francis Awino. I'm the current Bunge la Mwananchi President. And at the same time, I'm the People's President. Today is a very important day to us as Bunge la Mwananchi members. And I want to thank everyone who is here for joining us in whatever we are about to do. It is not because we hate our leaders, that's why we decided to go to Arusha. I want to remind you that there was a petition that was launched in Kenya regarding to 207-208 post-election violence. And the High Court of Kenya ruled that those people deserve their right and they deserve to be paid. But till to date, our country Kenya has never paid them. And that's why we decided to go to a more superior court than the courts that we have. But moreover, more of the reasons why we are here, it is so that we can go to God. Hata mahospitalini mkienda, daktari anasemanga mimi kazi yangu ni kutibu tu. Anayeponya ni Mungu. Na sisi kama wanabunge tunasema hivi. Tuko na hiyo strength ya kufaitia rights za wananchi. Tuko na hiyo strength ya kujaribu kuseek justice. Lakini hiyo justice yote mwenye anaweza ileta ni Mungu peke yake. Na kama venye Comrade Bush amesema, kuwa tunaopigana nao tuko kwa pichi yao. Tunaopigana nao ni serikali ya Kenya. Juzi nilifuatwa na gari tatu. Advantage yenye niko nayo is because I'm driving a Benz. Sasa hiyo Subaru venye ilinifuata hadi Lenana, nikaona hii gari tumetoka nayo town, nikaeka tu sports. Within 2 minutes brother, ikawa hatuko nao mahali. But nikasema kwa sababu hii ni Kenya na mimi ni mwanadamu na kuna sheria, lazima niende Karen police station niende ni report. Na nikaenda Karen nikareport. Nataka kuwarudisha pia Bob Jagi ni mmoja wetu. Sasa nye tulikuwa Arusha, tulimwambia Bob, endelea na kazi yako Kenya, si tuendelee Arusha. As long as tunafaitia rights za Wakenya, tutapatania pale mbele. Baadaye tunapigiwa simu tunaambiwa Bob ameenda, mabrothers wengine wawili wameenda. Till to date, sasa tumetoka kotini kuangalia mambo ya ruling. Hadi leo Bob hajaipatikana. Na ndio sasa sisi kama wanabunge tukakaa chini tukaitana kikao. Tukasema hivi, abduction ziko, watu wanaweza uliwa. Lakini aliye juu Mwenyezi Mungu ndio anaweza katupatia protection yenye tunafaa, na yeye tu ndio Mungu wetu mwenye anaweza katugard. Na ndio maana siku ya leo tumesema hivi. Mimi kama president wa bunge, wanabunge, witnesses wote, tukuje mbele ya Mungu, tulilie Mungu wetu atuhurumie. Kwa sababu hatufanyi haya juu tunataka. Hatufanyi haya juu kuna mtu mwenye ametuambia tufanye. Tunafanya haya juu tunafeel kuna mtu amenyamba kwa Kenya yetu. Na juu hiyo mnyamba inanuka mbaya, lazima tuifukuze. Tunawaambia hivi, mmesikia students wakilia mambo ya school fees. 4 months ago I was here. Nikisema a government student right now cannot afford to join the University of Nairobi, to join the KU, because kitambo student mwenye alikuwa anasomea political science, a government student alikuwa analipa like 30,000. Sasa analipa roughly 300,000. Sisi ni watoto wa maskini. Mnatuambia constitution ina protect education. Wazazi wetu wanatupromise, wanatuambia education is the key to a better future. Sasa education inaweza kuja better a key to a better future, and we cannot access that education, and we cannot afford that education. We are saying this, and I'm telling my fellow comrades, there is always a light at the end of the tunnel. Na mahali pana Mungu, lazima answer itapatikana. Hata kama tunaogonja 2027, tumekataa kuinherit zile mashida zenye tunaweza solve sahi. Kabla waende, zile mashida zenye tunaweza solve sahi lazima tungengane nazo, to make sure tumezisolve. Ndiyo 2027, sisi kama wanabunge tunamua Kenya inaenda mbele aje, tunaanzia mashida zingine mpya. Sio tunainherit mashida zao, tuanze kusumbuana na mashida zao huko mbele. Wanabunge oya!
Oya!
Wanabunge oya!
Oya!
Sitaki kuchukua muda mwingi, Julai ilikuwa siku ya maombi. Acha ni invite pastors wetu. Na pastors wametoka na
this is a special session of Bunge la Mwananchi, and we have convened it for the purpose of reaffirming our faith in our philosophy of the struggle as Bunge la Mwananchi. We have struggled here for the last over 30 years for social justice, but today it has come to a hitch. We are addressing the nation as an inherent part of national political discourse in this country. So we are here to affirm that Bunge la Mwananchi believes that the originator, the interpreter, and enforcer of the eternal laws of justice is God. And that's why the clergy is here to join us. As you have all been aware, over the last 3 months, Bunge la Mwananchi has been marching on the highway of history. We launched a petition in the East African Court of Justice against the Republic of Kenya, state officials, and other assorted criminals led by William Ruto for committing crimes against humanity. This historic petition is championed by none other than the president of Bunge la Mwananchi as the first petitioner, and Bunge la Mwananchi as the second petitioner. So all of us, as we sit here today, we are litigants, and litigants before the East African Court of Justice, such that if something happens to any of us here, it has happened to a litigant. If anything happens to any of us here, it has happened to a witness. Because all of us witness the atrocious injustices that were committed against the people of Kenya, and we were in the front line. So Bunge la Mwananchi must take a stand. And that is why we want to thank the president of Bunge la Mwananchi for convening this special session so that we can come back to God. Because as Bunge la Mwananchi, we believe that God is the ultimate. When you discuss the questions, the question of justice, God, the name of God must be invoked. And that is why we are here. So the philosophy, the ancient philosophy of Bunge la Mwananchi is that injustice anywhere in part of this republic is injustice to each and every one of us. That is why Bunge la Mwananchi is ready to pay any price. We are ready to sacrifice anything. We are ready to walk across the length and breadth of this world to seek justice. And in the speeches of the president of Bunge la Mwananchi, if you heard him correctly in the last sessions, he said that we will not just go to East African Court of Justice. If we do not find justice in the East African Court of Justice, we will go to the African people, the African Court of People and Human Rights. If we do not find justice there, we are going to go to The Hague. So let us be very clear. Let us be very, very clear that this historical undertaking, this litigation that Bunge la Mwananchi has launched, was supposed to be implemented in three phases. The first phase, and I want to thank you members for your solidarity, the first phase was the registration of this case and subsequent applications that were supposed to help those who are complicit, those who held the highest responsibility for the crimes that were committed, accountable. And I want to assure you, as Bunge la Mwananchi, as the Attorney General, that phase has concluded with flawless precision. Right now, the case is already filed. The Attorney General has 45 days to respond. And most importantly, she said that she will represent those who have been accused. And as Bunge la Mwananchi, we are saying, let me say this for the record before we invite the rest of the speakers, that if the Attorney General goes to the East African Court of Justice to defend criminals with public funds, Bunge la Mwananchi will hold her accountable to the oath that she took when she was sworn into office. You cannot use public funds to defend criminals. So we are asking the Attorney General to abide by her commitment during the confirmation hearings so that we are left with these criminals and deal with them as Bunge la Mwananchi alone. The second phase, the first phase was registration of the case, and that one is complete. The second phase, and that is why we have convened this session today, is prosecution. And that is the most difficult phase. It is dangerous. That's why we invited the clergy today. Because we are coming to confront our formidable opponent in his stronghold. The second phase of prosecution and trial of the criminals will involve collection of evidence. It will involve going to the scenes where the incidents were committed. It will involve unveiling the petitioners. It will involve unveiling the witnesses. It will involve preparing of affidavits. But you remember, the enemy that we are facing is the government of Kenya, which has no regard for human rights. In this country, there's a historical precedent of trial of crimes against humanity. And you know what happened to the victims? You know what happened to the witnesses? You know what happened to the evidences? There was interference with evidences, there was tampering, and there was manipulation of witnesses. So we are here today to ask the men of God to pray for us so that the integrity of the evidence that we will submit before the East African Court of Justice, so that the commitment that we will get from the witnesses in the affidavits is not manipulated whatsoever. Because we are sure that the case we have submitted before the East African Court of Justice has high prospect of convicting the criminals that are implicated in those crimes. So without further ado, I would also wish to highlight that Bunge la Mwananchi has made further applications to ensure that every witness that will be involved in this case will be protected accordingly. But that is not enough. We need the blood of Jesus Christ, because the enemy that we are facing has monopoly of violence. The enemy we are facing has monopoly of violence. The enemy we are facing commands the National Police Service. The enemy that we are facing commands the Kenya Defense Forces. The enemy we are facing as the machinery of propaganda. The enemy we are facing can get you wherever you are, you hide. But the only thing that it cannot stand against is the blood of Jesus Christ. So the people of Bunge la Mwananchi must unite together with the church to confront the government which has no regard for human rights. Bunge la Mwananchi must stand to be counted after decades of struggle for social justice. Bunge la Mwananchi must stand to be counted as a defender of the people. Bunge la Mwananchi must stand to be counted as a defender of the people, no matter the circumstances, no matter the enemy we are facing. We must remain united and we must ask God to cover us with the blood of Jesus Christ. Because that is the Son of God. As we have no other weapon, the only weapon we have is the rightness of the cause we are pursuing. The only weapon we have is the blood of those who are killed. The only weapon we have is the tears of those who are crying for justice. The only other weapon we have is the solidarity that we can get from Bunge la Mwananchi. But the enemy we are facing has violence. He monopolizes violence. So without the church and the prayers of everybody here, all of us are vulnerable. So if we pursue this matter to its conclusion, we want to assure the country that Bunge la Mwananchi will remain a formidable opponent against the authorities that perpetrated historical injustice against the public and the people of Kenya. No matter the cost, we are ready to pay the price, but as long as we have the blood of Jesus Christ covering us, we are sure that we will not go down. We will stand united as a people, and we will activate all our branches. This is just the headquarters. We will activate all our branches, the 47 branches of Bunge la Mwananchi, so that this becomes a unity cause for the movement. Thank you very much. I cede the ground to the next speaker. Who is
sema hivi, tulikuwa na scenario kama hii 207. Na tuliona perpetrators ndio walianza kuzunguka around the country wakitafuta maombi wasaidiwe atuwe kesi wawachilie. Bara hii sisi tumewakula mbele. Kabla waende kwa Mungu, tushanyakuwa Mungu. Kabla waende kotini, tushanyakuwa koti. Hakuna loophole tunawacha this time round. Ni lazima tutafute kila kitu, kila mbinu, kila mtu ambaye amehusika kwa hii kitu, sisi kama non government organization, kama Bunge la Mwananchi nyuma ya Frank. Wale watu ambao waliuliwa, wale watu ambao wako hospitalini wapate haki bila interference yoyote. Vile tunaongea saa hizi ndio jua hawa majamaa hawana adabu. Sisi tuko busy Arusha, tuko huko tuna file kesi, lakini wanaendelea na abduction. Vile tunaongea hivi, yule mtu alikuwa anaendeleza maandamano pale Kitengela, Bob Jagi, na ni mtu wa Bunge la Mwananchi hapa. Saa hizi ako abducted, amekuwa abducted for 2 weeks, hajulikani kule yuko. So what we are saying, raundi hii hawata tushinda, na sisi tunasema tutatembea na hatutawaacha hata tukue intimidated na njia gani. We won't be intimidated, hata wakishika mmoja wetu, hata wakishika wote. Tunaona already comrade wengine kutoka university, kutoka Gen Z pia watasema kama sisi wote tutakuwa abducted ama tuuliwe, watasimama na hii safari na wataendeleza. Bunge la Mwananchi.
Nguvu mashinani.
Bunge la Mwananchi.
Nguvu mashinani.
Thank you.
I'm sick because you are the same people who are in the street were being shot at, and today we are seeing that Bunge la Mwananchi is here with us. We thought that the problems that we were trying to address the other time were addressed, but no. Today we are facing issues of high fees in the universities. Parents are here with us today, they can confirm. Even those that were doing admissions in the University of Nairobi the other day here, were trying to pay school fees for their students, but they're doing registration and deferring the semester immediately. So the issue of economics in this country is still a major crisis. And we are here without fear or favor. The Bunge la Mwananchi, the initiative that you have taken and helping us, the way we are fighting in the street, you're also fighting for our issues outside. we acknowledge what you're doing and we're not taking it lightly. And we are not going to stop the protests if we are going to see anything that is going wrong in our country. Because this is not just the country for the parents. It's the country for the youth. This is our society. If we curtail the problems that are facing our people today, that's how we're going to make a better society. This is like the place that we are sitting here. Even the county government is irresponsible. This is a place that resources that we are paying our taxes supposed to be upheld. People who are sitting here deliberating on social issues are supposed to be sitting in very comfortable places as they talk about the issues. This place is supposed to be swept every day. So if we come out in protests any other time, we are coming out because we want a better society. We cannot be fearful. And if you're standing here, if you're sitting here with us, put courage in yourself. We are with you. The Gen Z is still with you. University of Nairobi is here with you. I can see my good friends here, Okuz. I want him to come and say hello. Come.
Viva Youth Viva!
Viva!
Viva Youth Viva!
Viva!
It is time, and time is now. I refuse to accept that we are slaves. I refuse to accept that we can be treated as slaves in within the borders of our country. Youth Viva!
Viva!
Youth Viva!
Viva!
It is high time for us to speak the reality. We can't be treated like dogs. And for us to fight these people, as my guy said here, that we are going to fight somebody who's very ready for violence. And for us to overcome this kind of violence, we must come together. Comrades, power!
Power!
Comrades, power!
Power!
Comrades, viva!
Viva!
It is now time. Youth, is now time. And if we keep on silent, and if we keep being quiet over our issues, we are going to be tortured. Comrades, power!
Power!
Comrades, viva!
Viva!
It is now or never. Comrades, power!
Power!
Comrades, viva!
Viva!
Dear Sant. But since we are not on the table, we can't be on the menu. There's no way we can allow some individuals to cause oppression to others. And as the student leaders and the people behind us here, actually we are supporting you in fully. You have now seen the way the CS have come with the Lacunas new funding model. You find that a student who should be in band 1 is placed in band 5. That is a vulnerable student. So this student is denied the chance to education. Now the government has turned education to be a commodity, not a tool to eliminate ignorance in the society. And for that reason, Article 1 of the Constitution says that the sovereign power belongs to the people, and it is us who elected the government to serve on our behalf. In the recent demonstration as the Gen Zs, you saw most of us were gunned down by the government. And the Constitution, Article 37, provided it very clearly, actually it is explicitly elucidated, that we have the right for demonstration. And for that reason, we can sit here, relax, and watch the police officers gun down the innocent people who are advocating for their right. That one we won't allow. And let me tell you, if we lose our fear, they lose their power. So long as you are silent, that means that we'll be oppressed. So for that reason, we must just come out clearly and we'll be with you as Bungela Wananchi. Our people, united, forever shall never be defeated. Aluta continua.
Taomba ya kwamba hakutakuwa na umwagikaji damu kwa watu ambao wanatafuta haki. Yule mtu ambaye alikufa kwa kutafuta haki alikuwa Yesu, na Yesu alimaliza hapo. Na kwa hivyo tutaomba na tutaweza kuamini ya kwamba chochote tutamuomba, Bwana ataweza kutupatia. Tusemeni amen.
Amen.
Bwana wabariki.
Amen. Tumpigia. Kama sisi Waislamu tunaaminigi na tuna ile ubinafsi, na iko kutoka kaenzi katika mitume. Kitu cha kwanza lazima ukutambue, mtume wale wanabii waliotangulia walipata shida kutokana na nini? Kutafuta haki. Comrades power. Kama mnasema nyinyi comrades power, lazima utambue Mwenyezi Mungu ndio wa halali. Mwenyezi Mungu ndio alijaribu. Unaota hata Nabii Isa alayhi salam ambao mnamuita Yesu Kristo alifanya nini? Alipigwa vita paka na wale wakuu ambao watu walikuwa anaita ni wanafunzi wake. Wanasema bwana huyu kweli ni mtu wa Mungu. Huyu kweli ni mtu wa Mungu, anajiita mfalme. Comrades power. Sasa comrades power, vijana kama nyinyi ndio mnachukua ile usukani ya mababu zetu. Kama ni historia ya hapa Kenya, mimi naijua sana juu sisi ukoloni imetupata tukikuwa tunatumikiwa na wazungu. Nchi wa Kenya, watoto wetu wanapotea kwa njia isiyofahamika, na sisi kama binadamu na sisi kama mapasta, kama nyinyi mapasta mnafaa kusimama. Wewe pasta, wewe ni mwana Kristo, mimi ni Muislamu. Hakuna hapo, hata kwa Bible hii mnabeba, hakuna mali nimeonyeshwa.
Katikati ya vita hivi, Mungu wa rehema, kuna waliopoteza maisha yao. Baba Mungu wa rehema, tuomba roho zao ziweke mahali pema peponi. Baba tunaomba familia zao usiwatie nguvu Bwana, tunaomba ukaweze kuwatia moyo, tunaomba ukaweze kuwafariji, tunaomba ufalme wa ajabu ukaweze kuwawezesha Baba na kuendelea na vita hivi Bwana, ili Baba haki ya watu wako Bwana na nchi yetu ya Kenya ikaweze kupatikana
na ndiposa tunawaombea siku ya leo. Malaika wako mfalme wa amani katika Zaburi 91. In the name of Jesus. Bwana na kila shahidi. Every week.
Thank you for honoring our invitation to grace this great occasion. I also wish to take this opportunity to welcome all our exhibitors, show visitors and participants present here today. Your presence and continued support towards the show highlights the significance of celebrating agriculture, agribusiness and trade in this region. Your Excellency, the Mombasa Show has over the years been committed to showcasing modern technologies and innovations that promote agriculture and trade activities within this region and beyond. Sir, in an effort to promote maritime within the region, we plan to host a fishing competition, a boat racing event, while promoting coastal tourism through our exhibition platform and the Showground Redevelopment Plan. In collaboration with the Mombasa City County Government and other stakeholders, we are committed to play a key role in harnessing this vital natural resource, ensuring it remains central to the local economy. So we are happy to announce that the 2024 Mombasa International Show has attracted over 150 trade exhibitors, both local and international. We have also witnessed extensive growth in the livestock, farm and dairy sections. So allow me to recognize some of the exhibitors participating in our show for the very first time. We have the Ugandan Consulate, NEPAD APRM Mechanism, East African Tea Trade Association, Ketraco, Kitui Flour Mills, which we call here Dollar, Mombasa Maize Millers, Grain Millers that we call Ajab, Kenyatta University, Tana River County, Jehovah Witness Church, Aquatic Plus Water Solutions, Lamu Nuts, Wild Wild Sires, Chamber of Commerce, among many others. We appreciate your participation and look forward to your continued support in future shows. Your Excellency, we wish to recognize and appreciate the following institutions for their support in organizing this show. One, the national government for the diverse support in our annual shows. Two, Mombasa City County Government for support in our marketing initiatives. Three, Kenya Ports Authority for their support in the hospitality and marketing sectors. Four, Mombasa Maize Millers for refurbishing the stalls that we call bazaar. Five, Mombasa Cement for what we are seeing in this arena today. Six, the cooperative movement, the Cooperative Bank, Greenbark Industries, Kavian Kenya Limited, Kitui Flour Mills, and Harvest Festival sponsors, among many others. We also appreciate the continued support from exhibitors and stakeholders in this region and beyond. Sir, I wish to thank the National Office through the Society National Chairperson, Mrs. Annabel Kirinya, and the Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Bertram Muthoka, for their assistance and guidance in preparing this event. I also wish
to appreciate all branch and show committee members for their hard work and dedication, which has seen the success of this event. Your Excellency, it is now my humble duty to call upon the Society National Chairperson, Mrs. Annabel Kirinya, to carry forward the program. Thank you, na karibuni sana.
Thank you, Chair. Our guest today is Excellency Honorable Rigathi Gachagua, the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya, Cabinet Secretary, Minister of Agriculture and Livestock Development, Dr. Andrew Karanja, Cabinet Secretaries and Principal Secretaries, Governor Mombasa City County, His Excellency Honorable Abdul Swamad Nasir, and the county leadership present, His Excellency Honorable Andrew Mwandime, Taita Taveta County Governor, the Acting Police Inspector General, of the Mombasa International Show. Thank you for honoring our invitation to officiate on the official today. To our valued stakeholders, exhibitors, and visitors, I wish to welcome you to this premier event. We appreciate your continued support and participation in the society event. Your Excellency, we take pride in presenting a diverse array of new technologies and innovations in agriculture and trade. We invite farmers, entrepreneurs, stakeholders, and the public to participate and actively engage with the exhibitors. Some of the notable strides made by the society in support of the national government's agriculture agenda include: one, embracing initiatives aimed at fostering innovation and sustainable development within the agricultural sector, establishing business incubation centers, allocating space within our showgrounds to showcase innovative, affordable housing technologies, engaging young minds in environmental conservation initiatives, creating numerous job opportunities for Kenyans through our exhibitions platforms countrywide. And now, Your Excellency, I am pleased to report that the society has made substantial progress advancing the development of the Mombasa Showground Integrated Land Use Master Plan from 70% as earlier reported to 87% completion rate. We are actively engaging with key stakeholders, including the Mombasa City County Government, to ensure successful implementation of this development plan. Some of the envisaged investment options include commercial and retail centers, sporting hubs, an exposition center, as well as light inoffensive industries, among, of course, very many others. We invite investors from both public and private sectors to explore the significant opportunities available within our showgrounds. And now, sir, as I conclude, I would like to commend Mr. Henry Nyaga, the Mombasa branch chairman, and his dedicated team for staging this very enlightening show. Your Excellency, I will now invite His Excellency Honorable Abdul Swamad Nasir, Governor Mombasa City County, to make his remarks, and invite the Cabinet Secretary for Agriculture, Dr. Andrew Karanja, to proceed with the program. Thank you, sir.
We'll be right back.